Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In our earlier video, we have seen how to enable cross-origin and cross-windows communication in client-side JavaScript through document.domain and window.postMessage. Refer the video description for the link. In this video, let us see what is the difference between document.domain and allow-control-allow-origin. The document.domain mechanism is intended for allowing client-side communication between frames rather than client-to-server communication. If you have one frame containing a page from mydomain.com and another frame containing a page from sub.mydomain.com, then the two cannot access each other's DOM unless document.domain set to mydomain.com. If you see here like mydomain.com and a sub.mydomain.com, the mydomain.com has a file index.html and sub.mydomain.com has test.html. The test.html is enabled with some symbol div with id inner div. The index.html iframing this specific file, the test.html through sub.mydomain.com. Also, it's have a script to access this inner div. So if you see inner div from iframe, we are trying to hide that. So obviously this access will not work because this are considered as a cross-origin access. So the security policy block this. Let me show the demo now. Like if you see here, like index.html, so it's iframing this frame underscore test.html through sub.mydomain.com, and also there is a script trying to access this inner div from the iframe and trying to hide that. So some timeout I set it for like demo. So then if you go to the frame test.html, it's just having some simple inner div with some message hello. Now let me go and access this. If I go here, yeah, if I go to this index.html and try to access, let's wait for the timeout. Yeah, if you see that the element is not hided, but you are seeing some cross origin error here. Blocked a frame with origin mydomain.com, http://mydomain.com from accessing a cross origin frame. So here we are trying to access the cross origin frame, the content from a cross origin frame, but the security policy is blocking that. So by default, you can't access the elements or DOM elements from other frames, iframes. In this scenario, the document.domain option can be used to enable the cross origin iframe access. So let me show that. If you go here, like again, same thing, mydomain.com, index.html, sub.mydomain.com, test.html. So only the additional thing is like here we are enabling a script, then we are specifying document.domain equal to mydomain.com, same here, like document.domain equal to mydomain.com. So what this will do is, while the browser do the origin check, instead of that sub.mydomain.com, the mydomain.com will be used, so that the origin check will pass. So the script will be able to access this specific inner div element from cross origin frame. Let me show the demo now. Yeah, if I go here, there is a file called index1.html. So just enabling this document.domain, mydomain.com. So it's iframing this sub.mydomain.com frame test one. Then if I go to frame test one, same thing, document.domain, mydomain.com. So here we are accessing that inner div to hide that. So if I go to this, let me access this. And now the hello is displayed. Let's wait for the timeout. Yeah, now if you see there is no error, also the element is hided. So the document.domain is useful to enable the cross access or cross frame access for between the parent domain and the subdomains. The allow control allow origin header is part of CARS, means cross domain resource sharing specification. CARS is a mechanism that allows restricted resources on a web page to be requested from another domain through Ajax request. A web page may freely embed cross origin images, stylesheets, scripts, iframes, and videos, but the cross domain Ajax requests are forbidden by default by the same origin security policy. So means we can embed the resources from cross domain, but we will not able to perform Ajax request. The CARS is the preferred mechanism to enable the cross domain Ajax request by retaining a special HTTP response headers that indicate that the cross domain Ajax requests are allowed for the target resource. Some of the old browsers may not support the cars headers. In that case, JSONP is the trick to load the cross-domain resources. Let us see the headers enabled as part of the cars specification. These are all the headers enabled as part of the cars specification. I am not going to talk all these. Like, the important one is access control allow origin. So this indicates like what are the origins allowed to access the resource. You can enable the specific origin name, let's say http://sub.mydomain.com. So while enabling the origin name, like, you need to specify the actual protocol, either HTTP or HTTPS, because with the protocol or like domain or port varies, it will be considered as a different origin. So specify the actual values. Even you can specify star, it means like all the origins are allowed to access these resources. Yeah, then like, we can read through all those things. The another one is like there is a origin header. So the actual origin of the request will be created through this header, origin header. Yeah, if you see here, the cross origin Ajax request, it's blocked. So if you see the scenario, I have a mydomain.com, then there is a index.html, then sub.mydomain.com, test.json. So it's returning some sample JSON data, test data. So what I'm doing is from the index.html, I'm trying to do Ajax call through this XML HTTP request. Based on the default security policy, this access will be blocked because it's a cross-origin request. This is the same thing for even though this is a subdomain, the cross-origin, it will be considered as a cross-origin and the Ajax request will be blocked. So because anyway, I'm not enabled any cars headers for this scenario. Now, if I go to this, same thing, I'm trying to do the Ajax call from index.html to this test.json in different domains, sub.mydomain.com. But this time we are enabling the cars headers. If you see here, access control allow origin, http://mydomain.com, then port number also, because I'm using port numbers, so I'm specifying the port number here. So this enables the cross origin request from this index.html because it's running under mydomain.com. Even you can specify star, means like any origin can access it, but I want to restrict only for this specific origin, mydomain.com. Now, one more thing, access control allow credentials equal to true, I specified. Why? Because in the index.html, I'm going to use with credential equal to true. When you use that option in the Ajax or XML HTTP request, this should be enabled as true. So even you can enable other headers, whatever you require based on your scenario. Now the access is enabled. So because of the cars headers, the access is the index.html can do a cross origin Ajax request. Let me show that now. If I go here, there is a index.html trying to do a XML HTTP request to this specific URL, sub.mydomain.com, 8000, test.json. So then I am again setting this XHR with credential. So we already discussed. So the additional cars header should be enabled to support this. Now if I go to this app.js, so if you see here, like I'm just sending back the JSON response, test data. So I'm not sending any cars header right now. So let me go and access this page. Maybe I will go to a new incognito window. So do this, open the console. This is fine. Yeah, if I do a index.html, it's saying invalid. I'm alerting that error, invalid URL or cross origin request blocked. Yeah, if you see here, it's clearly saying XML HTTP request at this sub.mydomain.com, 8000 test.json from origin this mydomain.com has been blocked by cars policy. It says no access control allow origin header is enabled. So now what I will do is let me go back here again. So maybe I will enable this headers. Now let me quickly restart this server. Okay, this is fine. Maybe I will close this window again and open this. Okay, let me open this inspect again. Okay, fine, then let me access this. Yeah, now if you see, there is no error, like it's displaying the data. So with that cars headers, so the cross domain Ajax request is enabled, access is enabled. Now if I go to network and see this index.html, so there is no difference. But if I go to the test.json, you can just see here, like access control allow credential true, whatever we enable, then access control allow origin for this specific origin. But if you try to access the same thing from any other domain, it won't allow. So in that case, you need to add that origin also. You can add multiple origins, or you can add a wildcard. Like, but most of the cases, better to restrict for the specific origins. The cars specification is very useful to access the cross-origin resources through Ajax without compromising the security policy. The access can be enabled only for the trusted partners. The document.domain helps to enable the client-side script access for the cross-domain iframes. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.